for more on this very important economy, the platform economy. Let's welcome two very special guests in our studio, Ms. Zhi Peng, the corporate vice president of Tsinghua Asset Management Group, and Mr. Sangeet Choudary, author of Platform Revolution. Thank you for joining us. Ms. Choudary, to you first. As we just learned, that platform businesses like Facebook and those e-commerce giants are making all the money. So how come all of a sudden these platform businesses are making all the money, I mean, even more than those traditional manufacturing and services platforms? Why they are so important now?
Right. This shift has especially happened over the last 10 years, and that is because platforms fundamentally, instead of building a product or a service, they connect users and businesses and different kinds of resources and enable these interactions. To do that, you need a larger connected user base and you need a lot of data and the AI capabilities to understand how to connect these users. Both of these capabilities, connectivity and AI, have been accelerating over the last 10 years, and that is why increasingly we are seeing this come up. And once you connect these users, these platforms benefit from network effects. The more businesses, the more users want to come. The more users come, the more businesses want to be part of it. And that's why these businesses are so powerful.
And Ms. Zhi Peng, you are in the asset management group of Tsinghua. So why these platform business assets are so important and so powerful, and many times become the investment target of those big investment companies?
Okay, I will answer the question in two perspectives. First is actually for our business, actually we are building the platform for the investments. For example, we bring the technology company, we bring investors together so we can well develop our business. At the other side, we're really thinking the platform, the technology, really changing the traditional industry. For example, the AI technology are changing the healthcare industry, changing the education industry. The Tsinghua, we are very much technology-based, so that's we look at this platform.
How is Asia different from the US or European model? The Asian economy seems to be taking a leap forward, right? I mean, they're so welcoming the digital age and so welcoming all the new products and ideas and technologies.
Yeah, there are actually two very interesting things about Asia. The first is that if you look at most US platforms, they were built on the back of existing infrastructure. You had credit card networks, you had bank accounts, so you did not have a problem building financial platforms in the US. In Asia, that financial infrastructure, for example, did not exist. A robust logistics infrastructure does not exist. So a lot of Asian platforms, instead of building on top of existing infrastructure, build their entire bottom-up stack themselves. And that is what makes them even more powerful and allows them to move to other developing economies like Africa and South America.
Okay.
The second reason Asian platforms are different from the US platforms is that if you look at both China and India, the largest platforms, especially in China, if you look at Ant Financial, Alibaba, Ping An Bank, a lot of these platforms have built their strength not on the basis of only a very good service or a very simple search interface like Facebook and Google have, but they built it on the back of real AI prowess because of a billion users on whom they've trained their algorithms. And that is a real advantage that Asian companies have compared to companies elsewhere.
Right. And your opinion, Ms. Zhi Peng, that in what aspects do you think China compete very strongly with global competitors in the platform business?
I would say two perspectives. First is technology. We do have a very advanced technology, very lot of talents. On the other side, the big markets, we say the demand side. So that's really provide us a lot of advantages on the platform business.
Okay. And my last question would be the global outlook in the platform age. What's your opinion?
Yeah, so platforms are actually changing every aspect of our lives. If you look at work, a lot of the future of work is on platforms. If you look at companies like Didi in China or Uber globally, they are mediating a lot of work. So one is the future of work. The other is the future of trade. A lot of traditional trade used to happen on supply chains. Today, a lot of trade happens on online platforms like Alibaba. Now, if you look at these examples, these platforms today have a big responsibility going forward. If you look at work, for example, there's been a lot of research that Uber is exploiting drivers or is making them more commoditized. So we need to think about new ways in which we regulate work. On the other side, with respect to trade, Alibaba has been expanding globally with its electronic world trade platform, and we need to see how the future of trade is going to move away from just control over the movement of goods to control over the data about the movement of goods. And so these are the kinds of shifts we need to think about when we think about the future of the platform economy.
What do you think?
I would say the platform will play an important role for the Chinese traditional industries upgrade. The other side is looking at the Chinese companies, usually they are, previously they are the followers, participants. In the future, I would say the Chinese company will be a global leader in the platform economy.